Oh no.
Popping off my pedals. Oh no!
Oh no!
In this video, I'm going to help you protect your bike from scuffs. All you need is some clear paint protection vinyl film. This is the same stuff that's used on cars, so if it's good enough for a car, it's good enough for a bike. I'll leave a link below to the vinyl film that I used. There should be enough to cover the top tube and most of the rear triangle. If you feel that you need to cover more of your bike, or you don't trust yourself to not mess it up, then you probably need more. But if you follow this video, you're more than likely to get it right on the first try. So this is some of the stuff that you're gonna need to apply the protective film on your bike. You need something to cut with, something to mark with, and something to measure with. You're also going to need something to help you make straight lines. After you have those things ready to go, you're also gonna need a little bowl of water with a couple of drops of dish soap mixed into it. Then, you're gonna need something to apply that liquid onto the area that you'll be putting the film on. You can use a little spray bottle if you want, but I opted for a soft bristle paintbrush that I happen to have lying around. If you use a sprayer, then you're still gonna need the bowl, and you'll see why in a moment. Okay, a few more things. You're gonna need a plastic object with a flat side to squeeze out water and air bubbles. A little ruler or a credit card will do the trick. Of course, you're also going to need something to wipe with. I like to use paper towels for this. And the final thing is a heat gun or a hairdryer. All these things are your typical household items. So other than the clear vinyl protection film, you shouldn't need to spend a cent on anything else. Once you've gathered everything you need, we can begin the process of applying the film. So I'm gonna go ahead and start at the top tube of my wife's bike. I'm gonna keep it simple and only measure down to where the curve of the seat tube begins. With a little bit of patience, making that turn is doable since the material that we're using is pretty pliable, but for the sake of this how-to video, I'm gonna keep it simple. So now, I'm gonna go ahead and mark the backside of the film up to the length that I need. I'm gonna use the ruler to mark a straight line as a guide for my cut. So now that I have it the right length, I am going to measure the width on each end of the area of the top tube that will be covered. I ended up using a piece of paper and marking the width right onto that, because my tape measure is a bit stiff and it could possibly scratch the frame. As with most top tubes, you can see that it tapers off a bit. So again, I am going to make my marks on the back of each end of the protective film, and then take my long straight edge to mark a line from both points. After cutting along the line, make sure to square off the ends, and as an additional touch, I like to cut a small curve at all the corners. Before you apply the protective film, make sure that the area is clean, then put some slightly soapy water onto the area. This will allow you to adjust the position of the film while also ensuring air bubbles come out easily. Before you peel the film off the backing, dip your fingers in the bowl of soapy water. This is so you don't leave fingerprints on the inside of the film. If you don't do this, it's almost guaranteed to happen. You may need to dip your fingers again if they start drying out a little before you have the chance to place the film onto the top tube. Once you have it in position, start pressing out the water and any air bubbles using your fingers or a small flat piece of plastic. While I was doing this, I found folding a small piece of paper towel over the edge of my small squeegee to be very effective. At this point, you can start using the heat gun to finalize the film's position. You want to do wide passes over the area and not linger too long over any spot. The heat gun can also help stretch the film around difficult angles. So just pass over any problem areas while smoothing it down to the contours of the top tube. After smoothing it all down, just do a final pass with the heat gun over the whole area. So that's pretty much all there is to it. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick time lapse of the whole procedure on the seat stay. We'll be right back. So that's it. Now you have a clear protective layer over your bike. If you found this video useful, don't forget to leave a like. Also, remember to subscribe to get updated on new videos. Have a good one, and see you next time.